We are live.
Perfect. Alrighty. Hello everybody and welcome to Community Gaming. I'm Flute5211.
And I'm Soul Slayer.
And we are on Let's Talk number 11, I think.
Wow, that far already.
11. Yeah. So we're heading into, we're gonna just do a 32 Prison of Elders for funsies. We've got a normal on our fire team, our trusty fire team, Snez. He's in the background here. He may chime in every now and then if he's got 2 cents to say, but he's hanging out with us, coming along, and yeah, we're just going to kind of hang out, do this, and kind of cover what we've been doing the last couple weeks.
Yeah, we've been doing a lot of stuff. To start out, I'm going to
You've been doing a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I'm gonna blather on a little bit about ESO, Elder Scrolls Online. I am actually loving that game. I played Skyrim, and I fell in love with the Elder Scrolls series. And it was just, it was a fantastic series. They did really well with the storyline.
Are you really running No Land Beyond right now?
I am totally running No Land Beyond just because I feel like it, and it's going to be entertaining.
Anyway, all right, sorry to interrupt. I just saw this giant walking stick.
That sticks through the floor when you spawn in. Yeah, it's entertaining.
In honor of 1770 sticks and musketeers and whatnot, you've got.
I need a bayonet. I need a bayonet, man. Towards your enlightenment. It would be so awesome. Jeff.
We have our, we've got our Massachusetts Minuteman over there.
I am.
All right. Anyway.
All right. Back to it. No, I am absolutely loving the game. I played Skyrim. I love the way they did Skyrim. It had a linear storyline, but it was wrapped in so much other stuff that it was just amazing that you could just spend quite literally days playing the game and just never even touch the main storyline. And they kind of followed suit with this one. You get one story, main storyline mission every 5 levels. And if I remember correctly, it's either 50 or 60 that you top out. I haven't actually reached it yet, so we'll see. But I am absolutely loving the game. There's a lot of things that they need to fix. Queuing up for dungeons. You better be ready to sit there for about 3 hours before you even get a team together.
No.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Well, I heard you and another one of our guys were playing one night, and you're like, wouldn't even let you all get ready, right? Wouldn't even let you all queue in.
Yeah, so, like, I'm okay with this. Our friend is a tryhard when it comes to the Elder Scrolls series, or at least MMOs.
He was a big WoW guy, so he's a, yeah.
Yeah, he's a power leveler. It only lets you queue up with people 4 levels within, like, above or below you to actually play it. So he power levels and I have to try to keep up if I actually want to play with him.
That's so crazy.
It's entertaining, at the very least. The crafting system is fun. It probably needs a little bit of work. But, like, running around, playing with your friends, regardless of your level, is still an absolute blast.
Now, lately, you've been on a grind, right, that's turned into a werewolf, right? That's been your big...
Oh, God, yeah.
Lately.
I'm going to be putting out a separate video on werewolves, because there's a lot of fact, a lot of fiction when it comes to werewolves. And a lot of people trying to sell you bites when they grab your money and run. Be careful of that, guys. For anyone that's looking for a bite, be careful of that. Most of them are...
Is that like people trying to sell lighthouse trips?
I don't know about that. I don't know. I won't sell it. I'll help whether I can, but... I will not sell, like, video game... In-game stuff for in-game money or real money. I think it's ridiculous.
Sit down.
But yeah, there's a lot of fun things about it. Some people have complaints about the like fighting mechanics, the combat mechanics, but I'm fond of them. Again, like they followed suit to the whole Skyrim thing.
What was the is there a storyline? Is there a sense you said you get one every five levels? A storyline
quest?
There's
a main storyline, and to keep
you
entertained.
Have you gotten through it yet?
No, because I am only level 29, I think, and I think there's like, like I said before, I think there's like 50 or 60 levels, so I have not made it through the main storyline just yet. But yeah, I think the reason they do that is so that higher level players can still, like, progress the main storyline, have fun, that kind of thing.
Well,
which is smart.
So like I'm gonna reference let's take Neverwinter, not the new Neverwinter MMO, but like the original Neverwinter Nights, like, you know, other RPG based computer games.
Retreat
from Dungeons and Dragons, they kind of, your storyline was fairly linear, but you hit max level at the end of the game, and then that's when you fought all the big baddies. Like, it wasn't like here we are in Destiny, where it kind of really doesn't matter. You kind of get in level, but you can do it without it or within it, or you can pick your in level rank and go wherever else. It was just kind of all progressive that way.
Yeah, I think they did a really good mix where you're thoroughly entertained by everything that you're doing, like, as you level up, because it does take quite a while to actually level a character fully. But there are endgame raids and all that kind of stuff where you can get better gear and all that kind of stuff. And it's I think they did a really good job of balancing it, so the endgame player still has something to do, and while you're trying to get to the endgame player, you're still thoroughly entertained.
That thing did not explode. Interesting. So what are you running? Tell us, what's your loadout right now? What kind of character do you make?
I run Khajiit constantly. I don't know why I like the cat people. That's just me.
Got it.
I like the cat people. I am
small
running
arc,
a
by the way.
Knight. Yeah, I saw him. I am running a Nightblade, which is kind of the stealthier of the guys.
They're a really sneaky cat. Got it.
I am a very sneaky cat. I like that. And I'm actually having fun with it. To talk about the classes a bit, the Nightblade and the other classes they have, they only have four, and I feel like they should have more, because there's... You have your sorcerer, which is your main, like, magic guy, which all of them can do magic and such, but... Sorcerer is your main magic guy, Templar is your main healer, Nightblade is your main DPS, and then Dragon Knight is your tank. But that's all they have. They don't really have like a lot of variety when it comes to that. And from what I've heard from other people is that with other MMOs, they have more of a variety than just one per. And I kind of like to see a bit more variety, so you can be a bit more specialized in what you want to do.
Right.
Alright. But I think that's kind of everything I wanted to cover in this Let's Talk About Elder Scrolls. I am going to be putting out a bunch of videos on Elder Scrolls as I figure the game out, because I'm still learning the game. But yeah, as I learn it, I will try to put up videos. I'm planning on doing, like I said, the werewolf video, just to debunk some myths and tell people what to look out for and what not to look out for and that kind of thing. So look forward to that in the future.
That's awesome. Well, I look forward to learning it, since maybe something I might pick up at some point. That's pretty cool.
I think you'd have fun.
I'm sure I would. No doubt. Ooh, I'm in a bad spot. Cool, so we're going to talk about a little bit of Destiny here. Like, actually, well, before we jump into that, because I wanted to kind of get the non-Destiny stuff out of the way first.
Alright.
Oh, you did not die. So we've got, we haven't really talked much since E3. We kind of had a thing, a short video about all just the whole, our thoughts on Luke Smith and all that jazz. Which also that same week, they also had their whole Red Bull thing come out, but we'll talk about that later, which is poor timing on their part. But, like I said, we'll cover Destiny when we cover Destiny. We did get, I'm super pumped, Mass Effect's coming out in 2016, and that's going to be awesome. They kind of showed, they teased a little bit more. I'm super pumped about that. They're going to be leaving the galaxy and going over to Andromeda. It's going to be sweet. And then we have The Division. They said that's going to come out when? March? Enemies die. You live. Is that what they said?
Did they say March of 2016? Because I remember them saying 2016. But yeah, Division, they came out with a... They keep delayed. Pushing it back, but again,
March 8th.
Like I said before, do it right. If it takes longer to do it, fine, but do it right. Have it come out right. Have it come out being the game you want it to be.
Well, they've been teasing out parts of the multiplayer, or the darkness zones, I guess, and what's really weird to me is you go out there, right? You go out there, and it's kind of open world, so you have other people who are also out there. And it's like, okay, cool, we just killed these guys, and look at this loot we got. And then you can, like, cool, all right, yay, we did a high five. And then you can turn on each other and shoot the other guy next to you and steal their loot.
It's a free-for-all zone. You can play with other people. Yeah, if you want to play with other people, you can play with other people. Just only bring people you trust in there. Because, yeah, this is like another, you can get like, turned on.
Group of people, like another, you know, fire team, for lack of a better, whatever the hell they call it. But I was like, whoa, that was lame. I thought that was kind of interesting. You can't knife those things.
No, you can't. I think they did a good job, though, with it. Like, at least from what we've seen, of melding PvP and PvE. Because it's like the PvE guys have some fantastic loot. But the PvP guys, they probably looted some other guys already, and they have good loot. So... Or, you know, like you can, like they did, that you can band together and have some fun. I think they did a good job.
Looks good. Hopefully when the final product comes out, it'll be good. Now, did you ever play Fallout? I think we might have mentioned that before.
I have not, no.
Because that looks super cool. I kind of wish I knew a little bit about that storyline. But it looks pretty sweet, you know. I'd tell you, if nothing else, the pre-order thing, you can get your own little Pip Boy, your own like little handheld arm attachment thing. I guess it's kind of like your comm system or whatever in game. I don't know. I haven't played it, but if you pre-order, you can get one, and like your iPhone will go inside of it, and you can do. You kind of operates off that. Looks pretty slick. So that looks like actually a cool pre-order. He did. Nope.
Sucks.
Dead snap. Okay. Sucks. Ooh, drop out of the sky. Okay. So that's that. That was kind of really the only other thing. Oh, Minecraft. Minecraft Con, whatever the heck is going on right now in London. And they just, Mojang just released that they're doing a TellTale style campaign, single person kind of campaign, which I think is super slick. Now, I've never played any type of TellTale game, but just the fact that they'll have a campaign, a single player thing, is awesome to me.
Yeah, I'm kind of intrigued.
I have to have something to do. I can't just. I don't know. My mind is too objective. I gotta have something to build, something to do, people to go kill.
Can't just say I want to build a tower.
I can't just sit around
and build a tower.
You have to
have a reason behind building.
Right. Yeah.
Tower.
Give me a reason for it. Yeah. So anyway, it looked kind of cool. The IGN had a little preview trailer of it that I watched today. I'll put a link in the description below for that. That Phalanx could have ended it all right there.
Yeah,
with one of his OP melees. Anyways, that looks pretty slick. I'm pretty excited about that. Ready for combat. Well, I think that's kind of it as far as. Oh, no, it's not. the biggest thing of ever that Xbox came out with is backwards compatibility, and how awesome is that?
Yeah, we'll see when they come out with a game that I want to play.
They've already announced Mass Effect. I'm sure they're kind of putting a thing up for the community. What is on my face right now? I'm gonna die. Yep, died. They showed Mass Effect. They showed Borderlands. I can only imagine. I don't know how they're not gonna bring back Black Ops 2 or Modern Warfare 2 and 1. You know, COD 4. I mean, they almost have to bring those back.
Yeah.
They're saying they're gonna have 100 titles that they're gonna roll this thing out with in the fall, or they're saying this holiday. So they're gonna be rolling out 100 titles. I'm super excited. I know I'm gonna be probably jumping back into Mass Effect and giving that a go. Just playing it. They say it's kind of been. I mean, I've seen some of the videos of it that they've showed, and kind of people showing the side by side compared to the 360 version and how it's kind of being rendered. It looks super nice. I mean, being it's just kind of ran on an emulator type deal. A 360
yeah,
emulator,
which I think
basically.
Is a really good idea, is running it off an emulator.
Yeah, and PlayStation says they have no plans on doing it. Yeah, that's going to be, I still say Xbox, Microsoft kicked the living crap out of PlayStation for this year's E3. Everybody seems to, how can you not say that they, anyway, that's another discussion for another day. Anyway, I thought Microsoft did a fantastic E3, and when they dropped the bomb of being backwards compatible, the whole room just went nuts, as they should have, and that's going to be awesome.
Which they should have done in the first place, but I'm not gonna.
Well,
they're doing it.
They're finally winning the console war. They're finally starting, like, the first time ever. A couple months, April was the first month where PlayStation or Microsoft outsold PlayStation new consoles. So. Yeah. I think that they're just trying to keep that momentum and keep it going. I mean, they saw the numbers, right? They've announced that they're going to they've announced that they've got a whole new they've revamped the operating system. They've gone away from Windows 8, like you should, and they're going to have based on Windows 10, it's supposed to be super fast and all this jazz. So hopefully, that would be awesome, and it'll be run much smoother, I'm hoping, with all these new advances. I don't know, I'm just excited to see what they got going. Oh, you're right in front of my face. Okay, he's dead.
Success.
You got him?
Nice. I just gotta get out of this load bubble. So yeah, anyway, it's gonna be great. I'm really pumped about it. I think they did a great job finding where they were lacking, despite figuring out, okay, we're losing, how do we come back and bring people back to our console? And that, that was one of my buddy's big holdups, why he still has his 360. Like, no, I don't want to because I have all these games. I don't want to get rid of them all. Which, so I get that. That's legit, investment. That I still have my 360. You have to put an investment into that library of games that you still enjoy to play. But I think this is really going to pull people who might have been on the fence about next gen straight over. Go ahead. Sorry, I cut you right off.
No, it's all good. Yeah, I have to agree. Like you said, we finally just started taking the lead in consoles from PlayStation because they tried to turn Xbox into an entertainment unit instead of a gaming unit. And then I think they're finally, it's heavy box. Yeah, I think they're finally realizing that they did that wrong and that they need to start focusing more on the gaming, less on the entertainment. And yeah, I think like you said, they're trying to keep the momentum going, which is awesome.
Well, that was much easier. Oh gosh! Except that guy's on our faces. Oh, really? Is this how this is gonna go down? Okay, cool. So, anyway.
Oh god.
That was our kind of E3 there.
Yeah.
Just a quick little thing. Even though I knew you were dead.
Yeah, it's testing. There's a little bit of a delay.
Iron lag.
Oh god, yes. So, speaking of which, let's just take a little bit of a tangent into Destiny Iron Banner for this week. Like every Iron Banner, first day, lag city. They just had so much difficulty. Like, I don't understand why they have such problems. Like,
well,
every time it starts out. Well, I get that, but it's always whenever the game starts, it like for the week, it's just terrible.
Enemies
like, there's
die.
So much lag. There's
you
so many live. Issues. But then, like as the week goes on, it's fine. It clears up. Like there are still some
probably
lag.
Probably because there are less
kind of
people playing.
Well, I don't know about that. That's the thing. I don't know
retreat
if it's like day one it gets bad and then like the rest of it clears up. I feel like the numbers can't be that far off that it's causing that much of an issue.
Yeah, I don't know. I will say, Iron Banner, I did see less. I did not see as many thorns or as many last words. I still saw thorns, but I didn't see as many last words. I know that's not a sign of anything to come because they still haven't fixed it yet. But
yeah, no, but I think Thorn is going to be a constant thing unless they come out with a nerf with it. It's going to be that gun that you see every other kill or every other death. All right, so what's on the to-do list to talk about for Destiny?
Now I'm back. I've got the batteries.
Ah, batteries. That would be an issue.
Batteries are a thing. Okay. So let's talk a little bit about. I'm going to start off with. We'll start off with House of Wolves and kind of the present state of House of Wolves. And it's not good.
No.
It's not good.
No, I'm sorry. The gear kind of sucks. The weapons,
the gear
suck. They suck. It's just the only
Although
incentive.
I do love this sniper rifle.
Yeah, but the only incentive I've had throughout like this DLC to do House of Wolves was the exotics, and still those are fun exotics. They're not Galahorns. They're not get stuck on exotics.
Right. Well, I think. I mean, I think we're seeing, you know, our raid fire team group, you know, even we were still struggling to stay together, even through the fact that we only had, you know, 3-person events anyway. Now we're hard pressed to find anybody. You know, I'm having a hard time. You know, I was about ready to go start looking for LFGs just to get this specific. I'm sitting on my Queen Baker's bow bounty right now. Having a hard time getting anybody to even play because they're all playing, you know, Elder Scrolls or this game. As you said, you know, there's really not much to do. I mean, the armor is only good for Prison of Elders. So there's no reason to get it unless you plan on running Prison of Elders. The weapons are arguably not that good. Arguably, I mean, they're really hyper-specific, you know. Shank burn. I mean, I have this awesome sniper rifle that has shank burn. I don't understand. I finally actually got a 6-Dreg Pride or whatever the hell thing is. Dreg Pride? Dreg Promise. What is this thing? It's the... Yeah, 6-Dreg Pride. I finally got one that has... it's got arc burn and damage to all fallen. So it's actually a useful one. As opposed to
the
void
like,
dreg burn that I had earlier.
But that's the thing. It's still, like, even so, the best role we could possibly get is Fallen. I get a Fallen-type gun, but there's no raid to bring it to. And when it comes to actually bringing it into prison, it's only effective part of the time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We're not fighting Fallen 90% of the time when we're in there.
Well, I mean, yeah, it's efficacy is completely, it's really not needed.
Yeah, so it's just, even with the best roll that you can possibly get for the new guns, it's still inadequate.
It's still not that great. So they didn't give us much as far as guns to grind for. The armor is only good within the prison itself, so it's kind of useless, you know, outside of the prison. Now, it would have been cooler if the armor they gave us for the prison was actually all areas of the prison, but it's not. You have to have four armor sets, and then, you know, one for each enemy type, and then you have to have, after that, you have to have it specify, you know, do you want intellect, do you want strength? You have to grind that out. It's just, it wasn't worth it. And we were promised variety, and we didn't get that either.
No, we didn't. It's all the same stuff. I don't know. I'm very disappointed with the Prison of Elders. They said it was going to be the thing to keep us busy if instead of doing a raid. And it's just, it doesn't compare. Even to Crota was buggy as hell. And it still, it just does not compare.
Must be so, I mean, I think it's arguable that the Dark Below was better.
It gave me the Black Hammer.
It got right there was Black Hammer. I mean, right now the best thing you could going on is instead of having one Felwinter's Lie, there are now five options for Felwinter's Lie. Which you need to get yourself a Party Crasher. Because it's the Felwinter's Lie with faster fire. Because reasons! That was Budgie's way of fixing it.
Yeah, add more.
Just give us more. Oh, that high boomer. Good step. He's gonna. So anyway, so that was disappointing. I mean, I think House of Wolves was fun for about the first two or three weeks, and then it's kind of fallen off. Now, one thing that they did do that I think was pretty cool is that they spaced out kind of the some of the enemies for the Grimoire, some of the different, I guess, events, I should say. So, because we've had all these different Fallen Hunted cards to collect for our Grimoire, and, you know, all those different Petras we get from Michigan. Missions we get from Petra. I don't know where from Michigan came from. And so what's cool is we've been getting new one of those every week, it seems like, and so we only have one more of those left, so I guess it's not going to last that long.
Yeah.
We only have one Grimoire card we haven't received yet. But that is kind of neat how they kind of spaced out something. You know, they've given us something a little bit, but
yeah,
I don't know. I think
you get the people who don't really care about that kind of stuff, and it's like, there's nothing left for me to do here.
Yep, I mean, we've got that. I mean, the guy we're playing with right now, Snez, he's not a biggest fan of Grimoire Hunter. He's not a Grimoire Hunter. So, you know, people like that, you know, you're not pulling those people back. So, which brings us to the Taken King. And, you know, they've already had the huge debacle over the pricing, not to mention what Europeans are having to pay for, which I think I didn't realize that because I'm, you know, American. I didn't realize that they have different, that, you know, if it's $60 here in America, it's $60 in Euro. Which doesn't compute! So they're paying, you know, a lot more for games and content than we are.
Yeah, so it's even more of a problem.
Even a bigger problem for them. Rocks the flame, which is ridiculous. So they've had that whole pricing debacle, Legendary, we've already paid for the content, we've talked about it, we're beating the horse there. They've already had that. Then that same week, which, you know, obviously Bungie did not want, I'm sure they didn't say, hey, you know what's going to help these people, make them really happy? Let's give them this other more exclusive content that has to be paid for. I'm sure an Activision contractual release, and it was already set to be released, and it was just very, very poor timing. The floor's gonna catch on fire here in a couple seconds. And I don't have triple jump on. Oh, I'm an idiot, Cotton. Yep. All right. While I'm dead, I'm gonna put on triple jump. So that all happened. And this whole Red Bull thing came out. So now you have to go. You have to find the 7-Eleven. Once again, sorry, Euros. And me, this plus 7-Eleven to me is 2 hours away. So once you find yourself a 7-Eleven, you can go buy some Red Bull. So with the Red Bull, you get double XP, and you get to unlock a quest line. It's not just one story mission where you get a Red Bull squirrel suit, you get to dive bomb into the Hellmouth, which would be awesome. I don't know if that's what you do or not, but it'd be sweet. You get it's a series of 6 missions, it's a storyline, and the floor is on fire. So we've got that, and you have to pay, another however much for that thing. And it's a timed exclusive. Gosh, I cannot stay off the ground. So we will get the mission eventually. We will get it come January 1st, I guess. But that's 3 months. So in a game that already has no storyline, that's already been touted as having no story, then they're gonna make you pay for it, and then they're not gonna give it to you. You have to pay extra money to go get another story, which should have had it in the first place. I mean, I'm okay, the whole Doritos get bonus XP thing, that Call of Duty and whatnot, and buying things of
that's
been around for a long time, and that's fine, and that's whatever. But this is story missions in a game that has already been told, said to have no story. Like, you can't do that to us.
You can't restrict something that it doesn't have, because then it's just it's overkill at that point.
Why are you doing that? So there's that. And then on the Red Bull can, they have Optic Flame Sword. And I mean, the only reason I've heard of Optic Flame Sword is because I've followed Benedict Cog for a couple of years, and I know that he was a Halo pro, but he doesn't do anything with that anymore, obviously, because Halo's not around right now. And they didn't. I don't know why they couldn't have picked up one of somebody from the Destiny community, but my best guess is he is partnered with Red Bull. He's like Nadeshot. He's part of Red Bull, so that's, I'm sure they just picked somebody who is the closest thing that they can come up with to sell Red Bull
games. Also, Activision, the whole Call of Duty thing. Yep. They probably already had his number on speed dial.
Yeah. Man, if they would have put freaking Nade Shot on a Red Bull can for Destiny, I would have been. I would have been so mad. Oh my god, the amount of money grabs that would have been to get the little Halo kids on the. Anyway, so that's part of that. So they've had all this fumbling of the Taken King. So now they're trying to pick up what. They had this great momentum from E3, and the pricing came out, and the momentum was the complete crap. The community got up in arms. They had... The Red Bull thing came out.
I didn't play through it anyways.
So now they're trying to salvage it. So now that we've got the... Supposed to have the biggest raid that we've seen yet, designed by Luke Smith, our hero. Our hero, Mr. Asshat himself. So we've got the new raid coming out that he runs the Vault of Glass, right? So, I mean, he's not bad at his job, he's just not good at PR. He needs to be put back by the desk somewhere. Come on, just die, thank you.
Enemies die.
So we've got the Taken King, we've got the... So there's another thing, you know, we've got this raid coming out, we've got, you know, we've got these subclasses we're going to have. That'll be cool. But Taken King's got big shoes to fill. It's got a lot riding on its shoulder. It has the, you know, the Destiny fan base right now is pretty, you know, pre-ordering this thing is not, you know, they haven't really proven that they deserve a pre-order by any stretch of the mean. And so because people, you know, we've gone through the two DLCs that people already bought, like when you bought the Super Edition of Destiny, you when you got, you know, Vanilla Destiny plus the Season Pass, so you already, you know, people already paid for that, they've had it, you know, the hype from all that's way over. Now it's time for those people to actually spend money again. And I don't know if they're going to do it. Taste, you know? Victory. I don't know if people are actually going to... Yeah, see? Ness says he's not doing it. I mean, I think they've got... A lot of people are going to be sitting around waiting to see what's going to happen, if it's going to be worth it. Because, you know, they've got to build back some rep a little bit.
They're going to have to do something. Cause
they got
to
do something.
I know half the people we played before, they're not touching it.
Oh, I got some force feedbacks in the feedback fences.
Huh.
Really? And so right now, you know, there are a lot of... So when Vanilla Destiny launched, they had a very awesome window of crappy games that came out. And they were able to succeed right then and there. You know, Advanced Warfare sucked. And there was really nothing else, you know, that it had to compete with. There was another game that came, Battlefield, that came out and it sucked, you know.
Yeah.
There was something else before Battlefield, but I can't remember what it was. Anyway, so right now, it's going to have the new Halo to fight against. It's going to have Fallout 4 to fight against. So it actually has a lot of things it's going to have to compete against for being a, quote, major expansion. And I don't know if it's going to be able to pull the community back too. I mean, yeah, the enticement of a new raid might, but I don't know. I think they've got a lot of ground to make up.
Yeah, and I think that's why they did this. They advertised the subclasses so heavily because they knew that was their selling point. Was
sure.
These
that's
look awesome? You know, you want to try them.
So we'll see what the Bungie update comes this week. We're supposed to be getting... Tomorrow's Bungie Day. So who knows what they're going to do for that. I'm sure there'll be some little bitty things online on Bungie.net to go check out. It's 7 months of the 7th day. I don't know. I don't really know much about Bungie. Apparently it's a thing.
Yeah, apparently. I think they're going to be doing it at 7 o'clock. So it's 7/7/7.
So there'll be all kind of shenanigans going on, I'm sure. Who knows what kind of stuff they'll do on Bungie.net. So check that out. I know when I'm up at 5:30 in the morning tomorrow, or 5 o'clock tomorrow morning, doing the reset, who knows what they'll have there. I don't know if there'll be anything fancy, but if there is, you'll know then. But so that's going on. They've been saying with their weekly updates, we're going to be getting a lot more information. They're going to be trying to build any type of rapport back up with what they're going to be trying to do right now. Like kind of getting us brought back in, getting us enticed to get back into it. So we'll see what they have.
Goodbye. Trying to recapture their fan base, and I don't know.
Confirming available missions.
We'll see.
I mean, I feel that they will. I mean, I'm sure that they'll figure it out. They'll come out of this somehow or another. But I mean, for a 10-year project starting out year two, you're not starting out too strong. So
no,
I think.
Really.
I mean, I'm not going anywhere. I'm enjoying it. I don't have anything to play till Mass Effect comes out. I may or may not have pre-ordered, may or may not have bought
may
Strange
not.
Coin, may or may not, mostly because I want a Strange Coin. And I'm just going to go walk around and see if I can give it to people. I'm going to go to my local coffee shop and say, hey, here you go. You can't pay with this. It's a freaking Strange Coin. What do you mean? If I had 16 more, I could buy a Gjallarhorn. I want some exotic coffee. I want some exotic coffee. Zer takes these. He's a jerk.
Why can't you? Yeah, he's a jerk. Come on.
So, anyway, I think that pretty much wraps up our last talk. I don't know. Do you have anything else you want to add?
Closing out.
No, I think that was everything. I ranted about Elder Scrolls for a bit. We covered all the non-Destiny games in between, went over Destiny shortcomings, and I think we're good.
Poor Destiny. And Snezbot, what do you want to add? A roving band.
Well, I mean, I'll tell you what, if Taken King doesn't really throw down, I know of at least 3 people out of the 12 or so that we raid with that are going to abandon it for Forza Motorsport 6, including me.
Oh, man. I tell you what, this last Forza Motorsports looked really good. I almost bought it.
They finally managed to cut a deal with EA, and so they're getting Porsche back again, which they lost for Forza Motorsport 5, and they're getting it back for 6. So, and the big complaints about 5 were there weren't enough tracks, there weren't enough cars. And now they're coming in with 6, and there's like a lot more tracks, there's a lot more cars. You can import all your liveries and your custom decals, and they're going to have weather effects. So there's actually going to be water pooling on the track and shit. So that's, yeah.
That's awesome.
There's going to be a lot of that going on. So we'll see what happens. And frickin', I mean, I can't even tell you how excited I am about Mass Effect, because Mass Effect 3, like the single player, I wasn't great about it, but Mass Effect 3 multiplayer was the best online multiplayer gaming experience I've ever had. Destiny is a pale shadow of that excellence. And, you know, Destiny needs to really step up their game, or Blizzard is going to pave them into the ground and salt the earth with their corpses. Because Blizzard, like Mass Effect, does exactly the same kind of multiplayer content that Destiny is trying to, and they do it so much better. So
Blizzard and Activision, man, they're same people.
Yep.
So we'll see what they do. I will say yes, and I'm going to give a shout out to our little fire team, raid team here. We have what was Pee Wee, the number 2 Mass Effect multiplayer in the world or something like that at one point?
It was something like that. I mean, that's how I met them, and by extension you, was through Mass Effect multiplayer. Like we threw down in gold and platinum, and it was a beautiful thing.
That's awesome. Actually, I never played it. Actually, Pee-wee and I went back one day a couple months ago and played it, because I'd never actually played the multiplayer. I always played single player.
Well, I'll tell you, like, that's the thing that I'm really excited about the whole backwards compatibility, is that if that generates some kind of renaissance of Mass Effect 3, where, like, if we can get some kind of, like,
it's right here in front of me, man. I'm ready.
Pee-wee and I, we will roll up in there with you, and you will see what the Prison of Elders should have been.
Well, that's what I've heard. Like, it was similar to that, and it seemed to be a little bit.
Oh yeah, yeah. Like Mass Effect 3 the Prison of Elders is like it's a cheap knockoff of what Mass Effect 3 multiplayer was. And we will prove it to you in spades when the time comes. But yeah. So that's what I got.
All right. Well, that's awesome.
Oh, and save that sniper rifle with shank burn for that shank boss in Taken King.
The massive shank boss. Yeah, I know.
Which you've been talking about.
You know you're gonna want it.
I know. I've been talking DLC. About that for so long. All I want is a big freaking shank with dual wield Galahorns. Let's talk. That's all I want.
And an icebreaker on his back.
And yep. Randall the Vandal.
Outsider. And Randall the Vandal.
He's actually after the massive shank. He's actually the final boss. He's actually Oryx's dad.
Oryx's dad.
Is Randall the Vandal.
Yes.
After you kill Oryx, you have to go kill Randall the Vandal. All right, well, that's enough rambling. All right, thanks for everyone tuning in. Again, I'm Flute5311.
And I'm Soul Slayer.
And to all you gamers out there.